Are you apologizing for me already?
Yes.
For both of us. I put myself in there too.
We're gonna be fine.
I know.
I always just lower their expectations. So better in the end.
You're gonna be fine. You took your medication.
You're so studious in your glasses, Tyler.
Thank you. Thank you. So I'm getting. I had LASIK when I was 18.
Really?
Yeah, for baseball. Most of the things I did in my life was for baseball. So it's getting to where they're starting to fade just a little bit. So I gotta get a touch up, but I'm trying to put it off as long as I can. It just makes everything just a little bit crisper. Nice.
Every time I'm ready to do LASIK, I hear a nightmare story and it stops me from doing it. I'm serious. I just heard one the other day. Stopped me dead in my tracks. I know.
That was cool.
So what spoilers can you give us for the rest of the season?
That don't get us fired?
Yeah. That would be nice.
You start.
Well, I guess the trailer shows probably a little bit of romance with Derek. That hopefully goes better than last time. The last two times.
With a mercenary. Wait a minute.
She's openly violent. Like, I already know this.
Well,
she's
didn't
being
know about,
honest.
You didn't know about Kate?
No!
I did.
You did. You never told me anything.
No.
It would have been nice if you'd been like, hey, young
know,
Derek.
I didn't know what she hey, so young know, Derek. I didn't know what she was up to. I didn't know. Listen, it didn't
no
start.
Heads up. No heads up.
It didn't start that way. She's been in some trouble. Kate's been in trouble since she was born. A good spoiler for the rest of the season. There is going to be... you're gonna,
good job.
Yeah. Did you get that, or did I say it too fast? No. There's gonna be a moment of intense reflection for Arjun, and it's gonna come, you know, at a cost. It's a really great scene, and I'm really excited about it. I just came up with that on the spot.
Nice.
Wow.
I think it was good.
Best
did you hear it?
Answer ever.
I think you're really
he's, well. He's so proud right now.
It was as thrilling as
genuine.
I think it was really good. Literally just came up with
that. That was solid. Congratulations.
So can I just say that I was really, really happy that Chris Argent is staying on the show, even though most of his family is dropping like flies.
Yes.
Yeah. Really glad that you stayed.
Thank you, me too.
And I like the bond that's sort of there. It's unspoken, but it's kind of like a kinship between Derek and Arjun. And they're almost getting to be like a kind of a hunter detective team a little bit. Is there going to be more of that?
I think, I don't know if it's ever going to get to be more than it was in 3B. There's a little bit of that this year, but there's also, you know, Derek teaming up with Stilinski this year, a lot of that element. I think the task is so big this year with, you know, the threat not being a single threat, but being, you know, coming from any direction at any time. And not really having, yeah, it's an individual thing. It's people that come in and we don't know who they are and what their motive is. I mean, obviously it's money, it's Deadpool. But I think because of that, everyone's kind of teaming up with everybody just because we have to. It's not an isolated threat this time where we can really focus on one person or, you know, one area. We have to kind of be aware at all times of everything going on. So it's really whatever situation we find ourselves in.
But I think that's something that Jeff has done well with, you know, like things, you know, get established in a previous season and we know that it's there and it's not necessarily, you know, a massive focus in the next season. And it might seem like it's being ignored, but I think we're always sort of playing. We know what's going on. We know what that history is. And it sort of still shifts and changes the way, you know, we interact with one another. So I think that's kind of a challenging thing about teamwork that is enjoyable, you know?
Now that Scott is an alpha and Derek isn't, does Derek feel any jealousy towards him because of that? Or has he kind of moved on?
It's a one of my favorite things about Derek is how much he's changed from season one. I think season one and two, even like the beginning of three, he would have been. I don't think there's any of that at this point. I think Derek's grown to realize that. The scene with Derek when he has Peter put his mother's claws in his neck and he speaks to her, that scene was cut down a little bit. But originally when she came in, I say mom, and then once I confirmed that it's her, I actually asked her, what do I do? What do I do now? And so for me, that scene was, you know, him saying, I thought I was supposed to be this, obviously I'm not, so what is my purpose? What am I supposed to be doing? And to me, it was always that she told him, you know, help Scott. Like, you're there to help Scott. Like, your role, those who can't do, teach. And you're not meant to be an alpha, but you've learned a lot from your failures. I always say failure is an opportunity to learn to get better. So Derek's had a lot of experience in that area. So he has a lot to teach Scott. And I think it's going to be invaluable wisdom and knowledge that's going to make Scott a better alpha than he could be without him.
If Derek were never to get his werewolf powers back, what do you think his role would be?
I think it'll be the same. I think it'll be to contribute where he can and to help Scott and to make him stronger, because I think anyone who can make the leader of the group stronger, it strengthens the whole group. So I would say that's why I did this.
It also seems like Derek's almost had a weight.
I'm really sorry, we need to wrap up his shoulder because of going back to being a teenager. Do you think that it's almost like he's able to look at what happened to him with Kate in a different light?
I don't know that it's a different light, but I do think that it's I think it's such a new challenge for him now. What he's going through, I actually likened a lot to my personal experience of when I stopped playing baseball, which is that when you lose something that's so, I mean, I play baseball every day, so to me that was an identity. I was a baseball player. And so when I lost that, you lose that sense of your identity. So it's kind of like finding out who I was without baseball. I think Derek's finding out who he is without a werewolf, and I think that's kind of playing into it more than anything else.
That's great.